Okay, here we are, Clarke Auction, getting ready for another sale, this time on Sunday, February the 5th, which is Super Bowl Sunday. You can start your drinking here because we finish in before the sale and we do have free refreshments and food. Anyway, with that all said, we're going to start off. We have a wonderful sale. We have a lot of clocks, this here being one of them. Magnificent, large size, probably French. Beautiful bronze work on it, Doré finish. Pooty figural clock. Behind it here from a Great Neck estate. Nice size paneled mirror, nice gilding here. Still remnants of the original patina. Urn of flowers, pooty decoration. Below this, I just grabbed this out of something place south last week, a beautiful Sormani commode, but that's not going to be until our next sale. Here, a beautifully, beautifully carved, really finely carved, I would say 19th century desk, has an oak interior. I'm wondering whether it was American Victorian, we're not too sure yet, but look at the beautiful toes and the feet. Really magnificently carved. I would say it's probably black walnut, estimated 1,015. Below here, one of many carpets, nice Persian carpet here, open field, nice fine quality. Okay, over here we have this wonderful and large Doré bronze clock. We had one similar to it a few sales ago, not in good shape and worse patina. This is actually from Sutton Place also. Behind it on the mirror, Italian, finely carved. Look at the big crown on top of this, gilt and black lacquered mirror. Nicely carved wood. And below it we have, this was also in the estate in Great Neck, and it was below this mirror, a really finely carved serpentine front marble top console with a sort of a cerused or a bleached finish, you might say. Moving into the main room, there's a bit of stuff here, but this Pieta d'Ora is back in the sale. The person who bought it originally loved it, but it was too heavy for his walls in his apartment, and it's back in the sale. Okay, we're coming now into the main room, and as you can see, with the warm colors in here, it is loaded. We're going to go across these smalls over here and back on the subject of clocks. Strange to have, we have a pair of these. Sort of as is, a little bit of damage on the enamel, but there's a lot going on here. There's like lots of wheels and stuff. And this one here probably had the movement replaced and it's signed Chelsea, but look at the bronze work on that. We have Le Coultre clocks. We have Chinese glazed porcelains with Chinese teapots. Here's a nice pair of Sèvres bronze mounted cash pots, or cash po as they might say. We have a nice set of, I believe these are mint and reticulated plates. More bronze clocks over there. We have a clock garniture set here. And a beautiful and large Sèvres mounted and lidded porcelain urn with a nice scenery painted on it there. And here, which is particularly nice, is a Chinese jade little table screen on both sides, decorated on both sides. We have some more Chinese porcelain there. Over here, while we're on the Chinese vein, we have a what they call a moon flask, very large. We have Japanese here, Japanese Satsuma charger, also very large, but I believe it has a very small hairline in it. Large charger. This was here is from Great Neck. This is a bracket clock. It's pretty rare. It's an English bracket clock. Pretty good shape, nice and clean. Some veneer losses. And two rare but collectible little clocks here, two figural clocks. And as we move along, you'll notice a lot of carpets on the floor. We have this one, I believe it's a Cashan. Nice center medallion, very finely weaved with animals on it. This came from a Larchmont estate. As we move up through the room, we've got gongs. Nice gong there in a Chinese hardwood frame. And we have a smaller one here. Also from the same Great Neck estate. We have a beautiful Louis XV style desk. It's actually got big, big drawers on each side. Nice serpentine end, serpentine signs. Nice, strong desk. And here we have this highly carved Horner cabinet. It's back in the sale because of a non-bidder. If I could think of his name, I would give it to you. But I definitely mentioned his name on the website, and hopefully as I'm walking along, I'll remember it and we can shock him by saying it. Here we have an 18th century, beautiful little Italian settee. We've lots of Chinese furniture in the sale. Of note, I think, is this just a very substantial, nice, large altar table or console table with the carvings here. This came from a Mahopac, New York State, and on the wall here, this came from Long Island, is a wonderful, wonderful 18th century Italian Rococo giltwood mirror, as you would like to find it. Nice original patina, the glass showing the age. Front of it here we have a three-piece, probably French Empire clock, really beautiful bronze work on it with the marble columns and the birds and the griffins. We have plenty of used furniture, as we always do. We got a pair of these Horner, signed Horner bookcases, Empire style mahogany. Below it, another Cashan. Seems that we have cornered the market on Steinways lately. Last sale we had three of them that did very well. This sale we have two of them. We have this black lacquered one, came from Great Neck actually. We don't know what model it is, but I believe it might be a Model L. We have Italian commodes. We have French bergeres. We have beautiful mahogany break front. We have this very nice Adam style, sort of satinwood and inlaid demi-lune console table. We have another Steinway here. This one's a very, very nice Steinway. This actually came from Long Island. I believe it is a Model M. Over here, a wonderful and large 19th century sideboard, nice inlays on it, nice big high gallery serpentine front. Years ago, they would have been beaten down the doors for it, but we'll see where it goes now. It's still pretty nice, so hopefully it'll do well. We have a nice grandfather clock here. I believe it's German, moon phase, dated 1769. Back on the furniture front, I have to show these because there's a pair. Really wonderful walnut grain. Nice size, great for the size of the bed. You can get the phone on there and not fall out of the bed looking for it. Okay, let's have a quick look at the back room here. We have screens, more used furniture, Chinese armoire, sets of Chippendale style chairs, etagères, French vitrines. Back now into the main room, getting towards the home stretch. We have this wonderful table. I believe it's actually painted on the marble as opposed to pièce d'or, but look at that sort of nice allegorical with the Empire base on it. We have mirrored screens. We have oriental runners. We have this very nice mirror here with the wonderful carved wood on it. Good age, the mirror, you know, nice with the age showing in the mirror. We have barristers' bookcases. We have Murano glass. We have Sevres cashpots. We have Waterford cut glass. We have Royal Crown Derby porcelain. And we have a pair of these Chinese urns. Look at the size of these, really wonderful condition. Came from Great Neck. We have a lot of good Chinese stuff on the sale, so they better keep an eye on it. Of note, we have this spectacular, I suppose it's called a tripod bowl, signed down the edge here. It's in a glaze, nearly like a turquoise glaze. And on top of it, you have this lily pad top with the, I suppose, amethyst figure on the top. Really wonderfully done. It's slightly as is on one of the handles. Then we have the spinach jade box with the little amber or carnelian rabbit on top with the little bun feet. We have a nice pair of French cut glass decanters there. We have a really wonderful KPM plaque, came from a local estate, but nice big size, signed and got the KPM mark on the back of it. Lots of silver and stuff, which Whitney will be getting to in a minute. We've got a collection of bronze dogs. We have this wonderful, I believe it's a Caldwell clock. We have Russian icons. We have Royal Dalton porcelain, Murano sconces, more marble sculpture. Lots and lots of stuff. And with that, I'm going to wish everyone a happy Super Bowl Sunday. And we hope to see you here before the Super Bowl Sunday. And I'll have a drink with you. And see you then. I hand you over to our next appraiser.
Hello, and welcome to the fine art preview for our February 5th sale. Let's start with this large oil and collage on paper by American artist Nicholas Krushnick. Krushnick was the father of pop abstraction, and his later works show much more crisp lines and bright colors. But here we have a 1960s piece. You can see a muted palette and a large collage segments. This is signed and dated on the reverse. I'll show you the second piece from the Sutton Place South estate in just a moment. Next to it, we have another work from the 1960s. This is by Walter Williams, an African-American artist. This is one of his woodcuts. This is called Fighting Cocks Number 3, done in '64. And please take a look at the website for the second woodcut by the artist. This work is estimated at $800 to $1,200. Here's the second Krishnik oil and paper collage. Again, you can see the nice large scale here, another abstract geometric work with nice sharp edges along here. Each one of these paintings is estimated at $2,000 to $3,000. Next to it in the same vein, we have a work by the Taiwanese artist Chun Ting Shu. This was done in 1968. You can see the artist's signature down at the bottom. It's from the very low edition of 12. This is number 9. And we do also have the artist's seal down in the lower left corner. This is called New Moon, and many of his works have these large moon-like shapes and very simple forms. This is estimated at $1,000 to $1,500 and came in from a local consigner in Larchmont on our walk-in Wednesday. We have a wonderful gouache on paper by Adolf Gottlieb. Gottlieb was, of course, one of the originators of abstract expressionism, but here we have a representational piece. You can see we have a boat docked in a harbor. This is from 1939. It's actually dated and inscribed to a very prominent attorney, Archibald Stevenson, down in the lower right corner. But you can see just how he's verging on abstraction here with these very large swatches of color and very simple forms, which is really what I love about this piece. But all in all, a nice piece of art, you know, even though it's an early work for Gottlieb. This is estimated at $2,000 to $3,000. Next, I'd like to show you an oil on canvas. This is by Gustavo Montoya. And this is very typical of the Mexican artist's painting. We have a small child positioned in the center of the composition. Very light, sweet palette. Large eyes gazing out to the viewer. This has a Mexican art gallery label on the back of the work. It's from the 1960s or so, and is estimated at $4,000 to $6,000. Now down below, I'm gonna take it back a bit. Here we have a wonderful little etching. This is by Jacques Vian. And this was from 1914, a wonderful Cubist piece. It's called The Small Mechanical Workshop. It's from an edition of only 50, but it's in really pristine condition. You can see it's a very strong impression, showing wonderful Cubist forms and geometric lines. This is from the estate of a New York gallery owner and is estimated at $2,000 to $3,000. Another wonderful walk-in Wednesday surprise is this work by American photographer Sharon Kaur. Here we have a C print photograph called Boston Creams. It was done in 2004. It's actually a reproduction of Wayne Thiebaud's 1962 painting, also entitled Boston Creams. Here, though, she's actually taken the time to bake several cakes. She cut them, she angled them correctly, she had the lighting down precisely to reproduce the painterly aspects of that painting. Then she turned it back into a two-dimensional form, which is what we have here, the photograph. This has a Bellwether Gallery label on the back of the work, and it's being offered with a $6,000 to $9,000 estimate. Another work from a Manhattan estate is this gouache on paper by Sister Gertrude Morgan. Sister Gertrude, as she's commonly referred to, was an African-American artist. She was born in Alabama, but spent most of her time in Louisiana. She was a self-taught artist, also singer. She spent much of her time on the streets of New Orleans, preaching the gospel both through art and through song. Here we have a work that likely represents a gospel story, perhaps the Bride of Christ. We have two figures down here getting married, and actually an interracial couple, which is so interesting. And above it, very faintly, you see her name signed, Sister Gertrude, in very primitive letters. She actually only had a third grade education, but was a very prominent artist and an important folk artist. This work is being offered with a $1,500 to $2,500 estimate. I'd like to show you another work that came from a local estate. This is by an Austrian painter, Hugo Darnat. This was done in 1888, and the artist is really known for his Austrian landscapes, but this is so unusual because we have a genre scene and a courting scene, and actually the figures here are really well executed. So it's rare that you see figures in his landscapes, or if you do, they're very small specks. So an unusual painting and a fine painting by the artist. This is being offered at a $1,500 to $2,500 estimate. Here we have a work that comes from the same estate as the Jacques Vian, from a New York gallery owner in Manhattan. This is an oil on canvas by Antoine Louis Barry. And he's known as a sculptor primarily, but one of the most prominent sculptors of animals in the 19th century. This is a very rare oil on canvas of a stag in landscape. You can see it's done in a somewhat primitive manner, but a wonderful representation of the animal, signed down in the lower left corner. We also have a wax seal on the back that does also have the artist's name. This work is estimated at $2,000 to $3,000. Next to it, another small work. This is by Howard Pyle. Pyle was a revolutionary American illustrator. And here we have just a wonderful example of chiaroscuro. You can really see here how well he's able to depict the faces using just specks of light. So a really skilled painting by a competent artist. This is estimated also at $2,000 to $3,000. The last work I'm going to show you is a lithograph in colors by Pablo Picasso. It's called Jacqueline. It was done in 1958. It's printed on a blue Japan paper, and this is from the edition of 100. It is signed and dated down here in the corner, both in the print and in pencil, and then numbered again in pencil 38 of 100 in the lower left. This wonderful Picasso lithograph is being offered with a $4,000 to $6,000 estimate. As usual, we have about 100 pieces of fine art, so please take a look at clarkny.com for the full catalog, and we hope to see you at Sunday's sale. Thank you.
Hey everyone, can't wait to show you all the great stuff we have for February the 5th, and I will start in the main room right here with this very unusual and unique eggshell finish, tessellated form, R&Y Agusti Paris one drawer desk. Very whimsical, has a nice gazelle horn style thing going on with the one drawer label to the interior as well. Really, really cool piece from a more contemporary company out of Paris that's doing some really nice things, especially with their finishes, eggshell, shagreen, you name it, they really are pushing the envelope when it comes to stuff like this. So something I really want to do well in the sale. Have a lot of recognizable mid-century, a nice early set of five Eames shell chairs, original labels with the Herman Miller. We have a nice complete set of Rob's John Gibbings for Widdicombe bedroom dressers, also with a mirror and a headboard. You can see the other pieces over here. A little bit of finish issues on top of the end tables here, some watermarks, but once these are refinished, these will be complete and in nice form, I would say. Could just take a step back, and I know it's a little covered right now, but this is a really monumental Greg Shears signed and dated dining table with a really nice double beveled edge glass, plate glass top, brass and chrome, very Art Deco, Hollywood Regency style, really a nice combination of a few different styles. Large size, great for a large dining room. You could really put a number of different chairs around this one as well due to the clear glass and the metallic finish. This is really in right now and something that I expect to do really well as well. Right here we have a Paul Evans burl, walnut, and chrome cityscape coffee table. Nice thick plate glass top to this. Some lifting and a little bit of oxidation and some veneer losses towards the very extreme edges of this, just as in full disclosure. But this is actually one of the larger sizes of this example, this model. I think it has something like 12 or 13 actual pillars, which are really nice large size. Like I said, and something that is very hot at the moment. Paul Evans is something that we are really looking for. So if you're out there and you have some Paul Evans, now's the time to sell. We have more Eames for Herman Miller. This is a aluminum group office chair with the original headrest and the matching ottoman. Nice sweet set here. We also have a pair of what have become one of my favorite pieces in the sale, a pair of Art Deco black finished and gilt accent end tables. Nice large size with a milk glass top. Great condition, very delicate legs. These pieces really make a statement, subtle but elegant, very nice. I like them a lot. We have a really nice set of Bernhardt hexagonal furniture. This is a sectional that also separated into four chairs, ottoman, and the elongated sofa here. Really nice quality velvet upholstery, original. A recessed base with the black lacquer finish. You can see a couple of the chairs here. It does come into a nice U shape overall, but These chairs are really kind of nice on their own. And like I said, there are four of them. So we have a nice large set sold as a set, one lot, one money, something that you should be looking out for online. Here we have maybe not as recognizable as a mid-century piece to some people, but this is Ray and Charles Eames, two bent wood, molded plywood splints, leg splints, for medical purposes. You could really see the extent of the Eames designers in these type of pieces. I mean, it was more than just furniture, it was medical equipment, it was also pieces for the office, and really part of the era, not just in furniture, but in a lot of other things. These are in pretty good condition. One is still wrapped with the original labels, so you know that one is pristine. So like I said, I'll keep it short and sweet, but these other pieces in the smallest category that I wanted to show you are some of my favorites as well in the sale. This is a pair of Ebba von Wachtenfeldt abstract and contemporary glass sculpture. These have garnered a lot of interest. Once you see them in person, you can really tell why. Abstract, a little bit whimsical, characteristically a little bit different than what she normally does, but also high quality and very unique pieces, signed on the base and dated as well. I think these should do pretty well, although nothing like this has come up for auction. So this is your chance to kind of get in at a first shot for these. Another piece, vintage in a smaller category, but also something that I really like, is a rosewood and brass accent butterfly stool. This one does appear to be vintage, although some are made more contemporary. A really nice condition on this, kept very well, reportedly purchased in the 60s by the consigner. Maybe one or two very, very light surface scratches. Does not need to be refinished in my opinion, but there is a really high demand for stuff like this right now. It's an accent piece, but also functional, also of the style that's very popular right now. So I would suggest checking out more information about this online and seeing it in person. And until then, I will see you on the 5th of February. Thank you and have a great day.
Hi, this is Whitney Brie at Clarke Auction. I'll be doing your silver and jewelry preview for the February 5th auction. Starting here with this Bucciolati sterling frame, beautiful repoussé floral work to the border. It is signed on the back and this is estimated at $600 to $900 out of a Scarsdale estate. One of our Manhattan pieces is this four-piece Mexican silver tea service. Nice condition, beautiful finials here. And now we'll be moving on to one of many flatware services in this auction. This is a LeBolt hand-hammered sterling arts and crafts flatware service. You can see the beautiful shape here. It is monogrammed, hand-hammered, signed on the back. The ever popular Francis I flatware service, large service, additional pieces here on the bottom. Everything is, there's a full accounting online, and I believe this is estimated at $1,500 to $2,500. And here is a Gorham sheaf of wheat flatware service, a really old retired pattern. Nice, it is monogrammed, no knives unfortunately, but really, really very nice. Here we have an Italian 800 silver figure of a centaur with a gilt decorated 800 silver putti standing on his back. It is on this large amethyst specimen. Really nice, estimated at $1,000 to $1,500. It is stamped with the national mark of Italy and also 800. A really nice piece in this sale. And just going through some of the silver lots, our miscellaneous groupings for this auction, we have a grouping of Tiffany, candlesticks, pedestal bowls, a lot of continental silver. Here we have an Oneida damask rose flatware service. There are additional pieces in the bottom. This is kind of an interesting grouping of relics. Some more continental silver, continental and American silver, some Mexican pieces in here also. This is just a big grouping of miscellaneous flatware. So it's not really a complete pattern. There's partial services of maybe two or three different makers and patterns, a five-piece toll tea service, and this is actually, it's quite attractive. This is a classic modern flatware service, more contemporary look. Nice and an interesting case. I actually really like the box that it comes in, but the pattern's also beautiful. So these are just more of our flatware services for this auction. And another silver service in this sale is this 800 German silver tea service, kettle on stand, teapot, coffee pot, sugar creamer, and large serving tray, all 800 silver. And continuing on with some additional pieces of silver, we have this Ilias Lalalunis sterling box, Greek company. The title of this box is Lyre. It does have the little pamphlet on the interior, and it's after the Olynthus coin from 390 BC, and also with this nice little holiday card that I found interesting. And here's the continental silver grouping, nice open work pedestal bowl, little open container box, little Vesta cases, and actually I think that this is really quite interesting. It's a little coral cigarette or cigar holder mounted in 9-karat gold, all stamped, antique English, nice. Here we have a black star and frost, little decorative box that I can't seem to open, but it does have coins all over it, international coins, continental coins, stamped on the bottom, black star and frost sterling. A beautiful little Asian tea service. We've had a lot of interest in this. It is marked on the lid. If I can show this to you, all of the markings here, all of the Asian characters, with two little sweet teacups, all stamped on the bottom, if you can just maybe get a shot of this stamp. Conservatively estimated at 300 to 500, came in on one of our walk-in Wednesday days. So this is a Asprey London sterling gentleman's set, and it does come with this interesting provenance from Louis Auerbacher's granddaughter, that it once belonged to him, and he was the inventor of vitamin D in milk and additional milk for babies. He invented a few different things. The letter is available online, and also this article that actually it showcased some of the pieces in this set. All sterling, estimated at 600 to 900. And here we have this openwork Gorham pedestal basket, nearly 27 ounces of silver, estimated at 300 to 500. Early 20th century, around 1916. One of my favorite lots in this sale is this pair of Gorham peacock form low bowls. Really nice decorative pieces in this auction. Beautiful, estimated at 600 to 900. Okay, and here we have a French 950 Debain silver bowl. Really nice pedestal bowl. I love the little detailing here. Stamped 950 with an additional continental French silver mark. Really small. It is right here. Nice piece in the sale, conservatively estimated. And here we have many assorted jewelry groupings in the sale, so I kind of just picked my favorite to showcase for you. Gold, silver, beautiful Mexican pieces, Israeli pieces. This is interesting. One of my favorite pieces in the sale is actually this necklace. It looks like just a choker, but it's actually a male and female form kissing. It's really quite well done and interesting. Stamped sterling. We have Danish makers, some Israeli silver, Mexican, estimated at 400 to 600. There's some gold pieces. And here we have a miscellaneous grouping of necklaces. We have a Tiffany sterling diamonds by the yard in the original case and box, along with this 18-karat gold Italian lantern form pendant, and also a garnet pendant on an 18-karat gold Italian chain. Moving on to this ruby bracelet, beautiful blackened 14 karat gold rubies, nice articulated bracelet, really well made, estimated at 2,000 to 3,000. We have a pair of 14 karat Cartier earrings, estimated at 400 to 600. And here, this just came in yesterday actually, it's a Montclair 18 karat yellow gold coral lapis and diamond brooch, all marked on the back, beautiful quality, estimated at 400 to 600. Ruby and diamond earrings, deco style, nice quality to the piece, really beautiful length. And here's an interesting piece, antique bar pin, diamond accents, sapphire flanked by pearls, consignor provenance. He said at one point he had someone look at them and they are natural pearls according to them. Nice piece, 300 to 500. Art Nouveau brooch, also a pendant, central citrine, pearl dangle and diamond accents, old mine cut diamonds, really nice quality to this piece, Art Nouveau. Here we have a 14 karat gold Lucien Picard ladies watch, hidden face, opens here, beautiful articulated band, diamond and sapphire surround, nice piece in this auction. Here we have a 14 karat yellow gold central diamond of less than a carat with a diamond and ruby cabochon surround. Gentleman's watch grouping. One is a Matthew Tissot Sea Nymph and the other is a 14 karat gold Hamilton. Two watches in the sale came out of the city. Here we have this beautiful diamond heart pendant, over 4 carats of diamond in this piece with the original receipt, Italian 18 karat gold chain. Nice estimate at 600 to 900 came out of the city. And here we have a pair of Barry Kisselstein cord, 18 karat gold and carnelian intaglio of a horse cufflinks. Beautiful quality, all stamped. He's one of our 1980s New York designers. Have a few pieces by different designers in the sale. Next up is this continental gold watch bracelet. Beautiful gold work. Antique watch movement. It is signed on the interior here. I don't think you can see, but the watch pen portion does come off from the bracelet, but I'm not going to open it at the moment. Really nice antique piece in the sale. Here we have a Omega Seamaster DeVille. Nice, and it does have the day date estimated at 300 to 500. Diamond studs on this little so you're able to see them well, nearly 3/4 of a carat each. Beautiful, came out of the city, estimated at 1500 to 2000. Chandelier form earrings, really quite beautiful design, flashy chandelier statement pieces, tanzanites, diamonds, emeralds, and rubies. And here, another one of our New York designers is Iraji Moini. He did come onto the New York scene in the 1980s. He was one of the jewelers of Oscar de la Renta. He showed at the Metropolitan Museum, and he also has 3 pieces in the permanent collection at the Louvre. Interesting piece, 18 karat gold crystals. It is signed on the back, estimated at 400 to 600, but we do expect that to do well. This is a nice little 18 karat white gold carved chalcedony and diamond accent brooch, estimated at 300 to 500. And here we have a platinum diamond and ruby ring out of Thornwood, New York estate. A little men's ring grouping, both with diamond accents. Oops, sorry about that. 14 karat and 18 karat. Interesting grouping, I thought. 3 pair of matched rings. We have blue enamel decorated, ruby here, and this is ruby and sapphire. Interesting grouping, maybe stacking rings. Quite attractive. Here came in on one of our appraisal days, Tiffany stopper. This is a Waltham pocket watch that's actually in an English case from the early 20th century. And my favorite piece is this little Tiffany ladies watch. It does have shamrocks on the backside, a nice Tiffany New York movement. And this altogether is estimated at 300 to 500. And here we have just an assortment that came in. Schiebler sterling brooch, 14 karat ladies portrait. This is a beautiful little Swiss watch on a long chain, quite attractive. Tiffany and sterling and 18 karat gold bow form brooch. This is Israeli 14 karat gold, Israeli turquoise, 14 karat gold watch, Hunter case. It is monogrammed, and a little deco style filigree and diamond pendant. Here we have a little suite of jewelry here. Victorian enamel and diamonds, ruby and diamonds, and another enamel and diamond ring. Maybe I'll move back here to this really interesting piece. It is a writing implement, and it does have this little tag on the top that says Marquis de Chiray, deposited with HS security for payment of legal services never paid. 18 karat gold. A beautiful enamel decorated French inscription here that translate to God in my right, which is the motto of the British monarch. Interesting piece, historical value, estimated at 1,000 to 1,500. All right, and here we have another assorted jewelry grouping of silver and gold, a Connecticut necklace by Ruth Berridge, kind of a Calder-esque pendant here. Sorry about that. Really quite nice, sterling, mid-century design. This is an Alexis Bitar little brooch. This is Paloma Picasso for Tiffany. Little 14 karat gold ring, another little interlocked ring. 22 karat, probably Middle Eastern design. And then unfortunately a single diamond stud, nearly 3/4 of a carat old mine cut. And here another antique jewelry grouping. Nice floral pendant with diamond accent. pair of earrings with turquoise. This is actually a cubic zirconia and enamel decorated brooch. We have a little antique garnet ring, bar pin, coral and seed pearl, little sweet antique grouping. Okay, and moving on to one of our diamond groupings, we have a little diamond tennis bracelet, diamond earrings, and three diamond rings. And here's a 14 karat gold diamond accented buckle form bracelet, hidden watch face, quite nice out of a Manhattan estate. And here's an interesting grouping of just some loose stones. The woman who consigned this, she traveled worldwide, and this was just things that she picked up during her travels. By no means am I saying whether they are natural or synthetic, they're being sold as is for what they are. I do recommend that anyone comes and views in person if they have any questions about them so they can save for themselves, conservatively estimated at $400 to $600. A nice little sterling grouping here. Sterling case, we have this Hans Hansen men's ring, a little cross with moonstones, golden diamond cross, and the most interesting piece in this grouping is this Kalo Shop brooch. Really nice sterling, all signed on the back. Nice mid-century brooch pendant. And this is one of three Judith Lieber purses in this sale. Really nice condition, no missing rhinestones. Has all the little accoutrements inside, the strap, the little comb. I don't think this one has a mirror, but this is one of three purses. We also have a rose form purse and a frog. Nice piece in the sale. And here we have a Chanel bag, leather from the early 1990s. Tortoise shell detailing and strap, estimated at $800 to $1,000. And just quickly, I'm going to show you this cashmere and chinchilla jacket. Really quite nice, it's Swiss. The pelts are in great condition. Unfortunately, there is some separation to the top just from the way that it was stored, but I don't think it'll be a problem to fix it. According to the tag, this is a size 8, and it's really quite lovely. Estimated at $1,000 to $1,500. And one of the highlights in this auction is a 2-carat diamond engagement ring. It actually just came back from GIA getting a full grading yesterday. So here is the stone itself. Beautiful, exactly 2.07 carats, and it is G color and SI1 clarity. Polish and symmetry are both good, there's no fluorescence, and it will be put back into this platinum setting flanked by graduated baguettes. Conservatively estimated at $4,000 to $6,000. Of course, it does come with the full grading with the location of any inclusions in the interior packet. And that wraps it up for the jewelry and silver for our February 5th auction. We hope to see you there. Thank you.